MLB The Show is your home for postseason baseball. It's Game 3 of the National League Division Series between the Chicago Cubs and the San Diego Padres. Hi again, everyone. Matt Vaskirjian. Welcome to our special postseason coverage of Baseball on the Show. With me is Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac. And Dan, lots to talk about here as we get ready for Game 3.
It's been a good series so far as these two teams have split the first two games. So essentially, this makes this a three-game series. That means this game is huge. It's a lot easier playing knowing you're one win away from moving on as opposed to one loss from packing it up and heading home.
All right, the stage is set. The starters get their final tosses in out in the bullpen, and we've got a good one in store for you, folks. Play-by-play is coming up next. Nelson Lamet gets the ball in Game 3 of the series. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Hey, this guy has a four-pitch repertoire, right? And those are a lot of nice options to have. You can go hard, soft. You can go in and out. And anytime you have four pitches, if you can throw them for strikes, you have the big advantage.
And stepping in, Ian Happ. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. The 3-1. And he lays off ball four, and the leadoff man is on to begin the ball game.
Batting second, the first baseman, number 44.
So in now for Chicago, Anthony Rizzo. Gets him swinging for out number one.
Pretty textbook breaking ball for the punch out right there. Got it to bend a lot, and by the time it got there, it had fallen completely out of the zone. Not much you can do with that pitch.
Into the box, Chris Bryant. Chopper to second. This will be a tough turn. Reined in. And that's the second out. The next hubbub, Wilson Contreras. In his career against this pitcher, he's 1-for-2. Ready with the 1-1. Too much bite on the breaking ball that time as it's well off the outside.
I'd be real surprised if he goes back out away there on the mound. This is a count for a fastball challenge, and we'll see if he's ready for it in the box.
Two out, base runner aboard in the top of the first. Lifted down the line and left. But this will wind up being a foul ball. Hit fairly well out towards straightaway center. Grisham makes the catch to end the inning. So they get a man to second here in the top half, but he's stranded there. And now the Padres get their first opportunity in a scoreless ball game. Alec Mills will do the pitching in Game 3 of the series. What's your take on him, Dan?
Well, this guy's kind of unique. How about a five-pitch repertoire that he has that gives him a lot of options for both righties and lefties? And if he's on, he could be really tough to hit.
Into the box, Trent Grisham. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. The 2-2 one more time. Is a swing and a miss. That's strike three.
Just tied him up with that last pitch. Pretty evident by the swing. Sometimes guys get in that protect mode so much that they're swinging at everything that they see, and they end up offering at pitches that they can't possibly do anything with.
Into the box now, Fernando Tatis Jr. Into the corner and slicing foul. Here comes the 1-2. He is swung on and missed. He got him. And so with two away now, let's give you another look at our playoff bracket as you see what could lie ahead for the winner in this series. Digging in now for San Diego, Manny Machado. Two outs already on the K this inning, so he'll be looking to do better. Now the 1-1 pitch. And he gives this a pretty good ride that time, but that's going to be up amongst the crowd, a foul ball.
Lucky he got a piece right there. He was definitely late on that pitch after seeing a previous off-speed pitch.
Baez fields it cleanly for the first with time to spare, and the side is retired. And inning in the books tonight, still scoreless here on the show. New inning set to get underway, and into bat next, the versatile weapon, Javier Baez. Two balls and a strike to Javi Baez.
2-1.
Good movement bearing in. It's two balls and two strikes.
Swing and a miss on a nasty slider right there. Always felt toughest pitch in the game. If you're a guy who liked to work the big part of the field, you were on that fastball middle away. That slider looked like a heater for about 56 feet, 6 inches.
The 3-2 pitch.
You can really tell they're trying to keep the ball in on this big slugger right here.
Is that an effort to keep him from getting extended, do you think?
Yeah, I think that's the idea, Matt. But he might spin to win if he starts looking for it in there.
The next 3-2. There's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field. Myers looking up. Gone to lead off the inning. Solo home run there for Javi Baez. And the Cubs are on the board first, 1-0.
Well, if you're going to give up a towering blast to one of the best players in their lineup, it's better to do it with no one on base. It stings, sure, but a solo shot isn't going to be the deciding factor in a game.
Standing in now, Jock Peterson. Lays off the slider ball. That time. 2-1.
Two balls, one strike.
Got him to swing under that one. It's 2-2.
Ooh-wee. That was some smoke right there. High fire right on by.
The 2-2. Gets him looking at the knees for the strikeout.
Big curveball for the strikeout there, and that came after an absolute missile of a fastball. Even if you recognize the breaking ball out of the pitcher's hand, it's so hard for hitters to sit back long enough after they've seen a really good fastball. Only the best can keep their hands back on those.
So now to the plate, Nico Hoerner. And there's ball two now. Lifetime against this pitcher. Just a couple of matchups, no hits in two at-bats. At the knees for a called strike, and it's back to even at 2-2.
Two balls, two strikes, a crucial count for both pitcher and hitter. So, Dan, what was your approach on the mound in that count? Do you still pitch for the strikeout here?
Action pitch right here, 2-2. The last thing you want to do is to fall behind the count, 3-2.
The lefty Jason Hayward waits in the on-deck circle. Now the 3-2 pitch. Is a wave and a miss. He struck him out.
This tells me a lot about this guy. He's done a real nice job bouncing back from that home run to strike out the next two guys. Sometimes you're going to get taken deep, but it's all about how you respond that really matters.
At the plate now, Jason Hayward. And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1. Second inning here as the Cubs lead this one early 1-0. Counts even to Hayward, 2 balls and 2 strikes.
Hey, I got to commend him a little bit. Lead off homer, and now he's one pitch away from getting out of this inning without any further damage.
Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. Ready with another 2-2. Fouled away. The 2-2.
Down and full.
Hey, this guy's a hard guy to put away. He's fouling off some tough pitches. 2-2 count, and he just seems to keep hanging right in there.
The pitch. On the eighth pitch of the at-bat is the one that finally does it as he wears him down, and the inning is over. Cubs tack on another courtesy of this solo home run. We'll go to the bottom of the second. It's now 1-0 Chicago. Half of the second set to go, and set to go is the veteran first baseman Eric Hosmer. The 1-1.
2 balls, 1 strike.
Lifted down the line and left. In there, a base hit.
Boy, just when you like to get one of those shutdown innings, the leadoff guy ends up reaching base right now. And you're looking for that 1-2 inning. Now you have to pitch out of the stretch.
Yeah, I can't tell you how that lights up an offensive dugout right there, getting that leadoff guy out. So many options, puts the pitcher on the defensive and in the stretch.
Stepping in now, Tommy Pham. No offer on that one. 2 balls and a strike. Lifetime in this matchup. Not a big sample size. 0 for 1. A swing and a miss there. 2-2.
If he's able to dot that sinker down and away and execute that pitch all day, you're going to see a lot of weak contact, and the infield defense is going to be on its toes.
Hosmer aboard here at first with nobody out. And another foul ball. Another try at 2-2. A bullet to first base. And they'll put the tag on him heading back to first. It's a double play.
The right fielder.
Here's Will Myers trying to make something happen with 2 gone in the bottom of the second. Time. A look down, and no, he went around. It's strike 3. Nothing doing there for the Friars. They're on the short end of a 1-0 score. And now the Cubs pitcher, Alec Mills, 9-1-2 due up. A little too far in. Ball 2.
Certainly know he's not trying to work around the pitcher. Sometimes the hardest thing to do is to throw a strike to a guy that you know won't swing the bat.
The 2-2 is looked at, and the count moves full. Now the 3-2 pitch. This one's flared off to the right side. Cronenworth backs up a bit and he takes charge for the first out.
The center fielder, number 8.
Back to the top of the order now, and that'll bring up the former first rounder and Pittsburgh area native Ian Happ. Bases are empty, one man out. And not a real good cut at that slider, and he's behind 1-2.
He's gone to the well with that pitch 3 times in a row.
Oh, and meanwhile, this pitch rides too far in and winds up hitting him.
Well, as a leadoff man, the team looks for you to get on base any way you can. This isn't the preferred route, at least for him, but hey, they'll take it.
At the plate, Anthony Rizzo.
2-1.
Sliced hard on the ground, and that's through for a base hit. Make him 1-for-2 in this one.
Hey, just a nice piece of hitting right there. He's able to keep his hands inside that ball, stay square as long as possible, and feed it into the opposite field for a base hit.
In now, Chris Bryant. Oh, a double play ball to second. 4. The second for 1 on to Hosmer, but it'll come too late to get them both. Now the Cubs 4-hole hitter, Wilson Contreras. 2 on, 2 out for him here in the 3rd. And he comes back with a fastball. 1-2 now.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating and feeling really good.
We'll leave it right there as he strikes out, and that ends the inning. Cubs strand a couple, but they're on top 1-0. Bottom of the 3rd now, and that'll bring in the second baseman, Jake Cronenworth. Pulled toward right center field. On the move is Hayward. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning.
Batting in.
Next to the plate for the Padres, Austin Nova. One out, nobody on. Grounded to first. Rizzo is there. Well, gets him, 2 down. Next to hit will be the pitcher, Denelson Lamet.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
Bases are empty here with 2 men out. Into center field, line drive, base hit.
You're talking about frustrating as a pitcher. You have the pitcher up with 2 outs, and he extends the inning there with a base hit.
Yeah, it's funny. I played 8th in my career, and the grind was to try and get the pitcher up so you could base that out and flip the lineup over. This guy took it into his own hands and did just that. By getting a knock, now we could have some issues here.
And he misses 2-1.
2-1.
And that one right down Main Street.
Might have been taking all the way right there. That pitch couldn't have split the strike zone any better. And you can bet he wants that one back at the plate.
Well hit the other way, and it's into the gap. So now they'll have two men in scoring position following the two-out double.
This guy just feasts on mistakes up of the zone, and that's exactly what he gets right here. A belt-high pitch, he drives into the alley. Great chance now with two runners in scoring position.
Standing in now, Fernando Tatis Jr. Line drive, base hit. And not in time. The run scores. Now a good throw in will hold that second runner at third base, so they're at the corners now with two away.
Boy, there are big RBIs and big base hits, Nero, but none more than with two outs. A big two-out knock right there. Not only ties things up, but keeps the inning going as well.
Yeah, just a great approach right there by the batter. You never know when your number's going to be called. You always want to pass the baton to the next guy behind you. Take the donut off your bat and trust in the teammate behind you. That is a huge knock and keeps the line moving.
The set and the 1-2. A swing and a miss on a ball way outside the strike zone, and the inning is over. Friars forced to settle for just the one. Start of the fourth upcoming, but first, Heidi Watney standing by with a report.
Thanks, Matt. In between innings, I was able to catch up with the manager of the Cubs to discuss his thoughts on his lineup so far. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. Yes, they've only scored one run, but he said they've done a great job of forcing the pitch count up, and he thinks that's going to lead to more offense for them as this game goes on.
Thank you, Heidi. All set for the start of the fourth, and stepping in is the veteran shortstop, Javier Baez.
Well, Maddie, we know he's got the timing on the fastball locked in. That's what he got a hold of on that home run in the previous at bat. You do not come off the heater. Have to be leery of the off speed, but stay on the fastball. He's got to throw it again.
Got him to miss the breaking ball there. Javier Baez is retired to kick off the inning. Into the box now, Jock Peterson. Up high, 2-1 now.
That's a good take on a fastball out of the zone. Hey, I get it. He's looking for a ball to drive, but that ball was a little bit too far up in the zone. That's one you normally pop right up.
And that is in there at the letters to run it full, 3-2. Holds off on the slider, and that's a good idea as it's ball four.
Well, when you go with the slider there in a full count, you're hoping that the hitter is thinking fastball and swings through it. Didn't work out that way, though. He lays off and gets the free pass.
So one gone in the inning here with a runner at first. And up next, Nico Hoerner. Now the 3-2 pitch. Hit the other way out toward right field. Myers is under it, and that's the second out of the inning. So stepping in is Jason Hayward. 0-for-1, went down looking his first time up.
Yeah, in today's game, certainly don't get completely reprimanded for too many strikeouts, but no one likes to go down looking. Expect him to be a little bit more aggressive at the dish, this AB.
Runner aboard at first here with two gone in a 1-1 ball game. And he struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. Cubs strand one. On to the bottom of the fourth, tied 1-1. Welcome back to Baltimore as we send you down to check in with Heidi Watney.
Matt, I talked with San Diego's manager during the inning break about the Padres' offensive production to this point. And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. Yes, they've only scored one run, but he said they've done a great job of forcing the pitch count up, and he thinks that's going to lead to more offense for them as this game goes on.
All right, thanks, Heidi. First baseman Eric Hosmer is in. The 1-1 home.
No, that's out.
This guy's been really on point so far, but it's not getting any easier. He has to get through 4, 5, and 6 right here.
And this is lined into left field, and the leadoff man will reach. It's a base hit.
How frustrating is that, Dan? He tries to bury something in with two strikes, and this guy's able to put bat on baseball and find a way to hit a soft liner to the opposite field.
You know, sometimes you have to tip your cap. That inside-out swing as a pitcher, you think you've thrown a good pitch, but sometimes as a hitter, they put a good swing on it and still ends up for a base hit.
At the plate now, Tommy Pham.
No, that missed. That's the ball.
Breaking ball called just a bit low.
Full count.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
And there's a base hit on the line. And that runner will hold up at second with two aboard now.
These guys are in perfect position to break through right here and to take the lead. There is, without question, nothing tougher than back-to-back singles. You don't know if they're going to bunt. You don't know. They can do so. They have so many options at their disposal right now.
Stepping in now, Will Myers.
Oh.
Two balls and a strike now as that misses to the San Diego right fielder.
Hey, time to start making some quality pitches. He finds himself in a tough spot behind an account with guys on base.
Grounded down the third baseline, but this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. From the stretch. Fastball pulled, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning.
Just flat out frozen there. Nothing too deceptive about that four-seam fastball, so I think he wasn't expecting it at all.
To the plate now, Jake Cronenworth. And that's into the corner, a foul ball and right.
I mean, he's coming right after him, Matty. Three fastballs in a row.
Here comes the 1-2. Looked after ball number two.
2-2.
Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. The 2-2. Hit to third. One there. Relay to first in time. And just like that, the side is retired. That's how you roll it. 5-4-3. A double play sends us to break. We'll have more of game three after this message. All ready to go in the top of the fifth. And next will be the pitcher, Alec Mills. Now the 1-1 pitch. Lifted down the line and left. And that will end up a foul ball. A ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. And he struck him out. And that's 8 strikeouts thus far.
That swing tells me he was really trying to get a pitch out front and rip it down the line. But that wasn't a great pitch to do it on. It's really not the best 2-strike approach either.
So now to the plate, Ian Happ. Happ with a 2-1 count now. Action now in the Padre bullpen as it looks like a right-hander's getting loose out there. windup. Here's the 2-1 pitch.
Boy, he just threw that fastball by him.
Really feels like he's just on cruise control out there on the mound right now.
Boy, this is the tight one. You kind of get the feeling like the next team that scores is going to win this one.
One run, two hits. No errors so far for the Cubbies.
And that one yanked just foul.
Pulled toward right center field. Myers is under it. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away. Anthony Rizzo stands in now. He's one for two in the ballgame. And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1.
Two-out lightning definitely applies to this offense. If this two-hole hitter can get on, they could start something serious.
Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. Into the windup. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. Good eye to lay off the slider there, and he works it to full 3-2 here.
Not a time to fool around right now on a 3-2 count with the middle part of the order coming up. Expect a good pitch to swing at.
And awfully close there on 3-2, but take your base, says Earl Hendricks. It's ball four.
Well, he gives up the walk, but that was a really good pitch. Might have been just out of the zone, but not by much. A lot of guys would have gone fishing for that pitch, so sometimes the hitter just outlasts you.
Into the box, Chris Bryant swung on and hit pretty well out to deep left field. And this will get all the way to the wall now. Absolutely scorched that base hit. Worthy of some show track love, and as you see, it came off the bat at 110 miles an hour. That's definitely squaring a ball up. Standing in now, Wilson Contreras. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Rizzo over at second. Bryant at first, two out in the inning. In the dirt here. And a nice job to keep the runners at bay as the count moves to 2-2. 2-2, the pitch.
Now, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
And he's got himself another one as he picks up strikeout number 9 here, and the side is retired. A big-time strikeout and some raw emotion as he gets out of the jam. Back with more from Game 3 after this. That'll bring up Austin Nola as we move past the halfway point in this one and begin the bottom of the fifth. So far, here's the 3-2. And I might have jinxed him as he misses there for ball four.
And that's what you want from your leadoff hitter. Show some great patience and discipline, making the pitcher labor to start the game. The result is a leadoff walk and a chance to make some early noise.
Brian O'Grady will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Number 5, Brian O'Grady.
Leadoff man aboard here in a 1-1 ball game. And
And this is low, ball two. 2-1. Lifetime versus this pitcher. Small sample, a perfect 1-for-1. He's falling behind now, 3-1.
This situation right here reminds me of sitting on the bench talking to John Smoltz, Hall of Famer. He would always say, even though the situation looked bad, a pitcher is one pitch away from getting himself out of a tough jam.
Swung out and missed, 3-2.
You have to find a way to lay off that low sinker. There is just no way to do any damage. You're just looking at either a bruised shin or a ground out to the left side.
To second for one on the Rizzo, but a little slow in developing as they'll just get the one out. So it's back to the top of the order now, and that brings up Trent Grisham. Runner on first here with one gone and a 1-1 tie. Pulled toward right center field. Long run for the center fielder. He's got it. A nice play there. Two away. So a runner at first with two away. And up steps the big bat of Fernando Tatis Jr. A 3-2 pitch. Hit sharply on the ground. And he'll reach first as they can't make the play on it. We'll chalk that one up as a 6. You really can't believe it out there. So it's first and second with two men gone, and that'll bring in Manny Machado. In the air out towards shallow right. Hayward has a read on it. He hauls it in, and the potential go-ahead run will not come around to score. Padres leave a pair. We've played five full, tied at one aside. Craig Stammen takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound.
Now pitching for the Padres, number 34, Craig Stammen.
Here's Javier Baez. He went down on strikes last time up. The 3-1. Tough pitch to lay off, but he did, and it's ball four, so the leadoff hitter is aboard to start the sixth.
Man, when the game is tied, the last thing you can afford to do is walk the leadoff hitter. Got to focus on getting that ground ball now.
So a runner at first now with nobody out. And in steps a former World Series hero, the outfielder Jock Peterson. A 3-1 pitch. Lifted down the line and left. But this will wind up being a foul ball. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Fires. Gets his lead at first, nobody out. This is hit pretty well out to left field. And he's going to make the catch on the warning track. A fine running play there for the first out. Next to stand in is Nico Horner. He flew out in his last AB. The 2-1 is swung on and missed for strike number two. One run on three hits, one error for the Cubs to this point. And he takes ball three, so it's a full count now.
Not a bad time right here to put that runner in motion. 3-2 count, you send the runner, and if it's a bad pitch, it's ball four.
Pitch home. 3-2, but take your base, says Earl Hendricks. It's ball four.
I know one thing. He earned that free pass right there. He was tempted with some really good pitches, but he stayed disciplined and drew the walk.
And now in the box, Jason Hayward. He went down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
The 2-2 is laid off, and the count runs full. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. Fouls this one off. Seventh pitch of the at-bat coming up. And he misses again. Ball four. That's back-to-back guys now that have reached base field and base on ball.
That's a big no-no. He obviously had to work carefully with two men on, but he did not want to walk him to load the bases. Now he's really got his work cut out for him. We'll see how he fares here.
So here now is the pitcher, Alec Mills. He's 0 for 2 in the ballgame so far. A 1-1. Rounded weakly to the right side. And indeed, he'll take only the out at first as the run comes in to score.
Really good job of putting the ball in play right there. Even though it wasn't a base hit, it does bring the go-ahead run for his team.
And that'll bring in the Pittsburgh area native Ian Happ. Lifetime versus Craig Stammen. He's 1 for 2. Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. Hosmer has it. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. So it winds up being a run on no hits, and they leave two men on for the bottom of the sixth inning. The Cubs lead this one 2-1. Ryan Tepera enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Number 52, Ryan Tepera.
Bottom of the sixth inning now, and standing in, here's the first baseman, Eric Hosmer. Now the 1-1 pitch.
Bobby Cox always used to say, I'm going to put you in positions to be successful. Well, against a modern-day bullpen, easier said than done. These guys are throwing flames from all arm angles.
The 2-1. Grounded to short. Baez has it. Throws in time, and that's out number one. Next, it'll be Tommy Pham. Last time through was a base hit. Now the 3-2 pitch. Ground ball right side. Fielded cleanly. And there are two away now. Next, it'll be Will Myers. He's hoping to avoid the hat trick. Struck out in each of his first two plate appearances so far. The 1-1. Pops this one up, and this will not be caught. It's a foul ball.
Man, you don't see this in today's game that much. A guy who's willing to work east-west consistently with a great cutter two-seamer combo.
This should end the inning as it's sent out to second. Throw pulls the first baseman off the bag.
This is a head-scratcher. I mean, that's the shortest throw on the infield, and somehow he lets it sail wide of the mark for an E4.
couple more like that, and doubt starts to creep into the second baseman's mind.
Brad Wick comes on now, and this move looks to be all about playing the matchup here.
Yeah, and I don't think there's any doubt about that, Matt. They want the lefty-lefty matchup, and that's usually the right move, but we'll just have to see how this plays out.
At the plate, Jake Cronenworth.
Three balls, one strike.
He's fallen behind now, 3-1. Austin Nola would be next if they can keep this inning alive. Myers leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. 3-2.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Fouled off. Spoils another one, and we'll do it again. Still 3 balls and 2 strikes, the 8th pitch of the at-bat. Had the weight back on the changeup, and he did a good job just to make contact. Oh, he rips this one the other way, but caught down there at third. Needed just a little more height on that one, but instead, the inning is over. Set for the start of the inning, and here comes the first baseman, Anthony Rizzo. And the pitch on 2-1, hit in the air out to center field. Grisham is under it to make the catch for out number one. Digging in next will be Chris Bryant. Lifetime versus Craig Stammen. He's hitless in 3 at-bats. Here comes the payoff pitch. Throw on to first, 2 gone. So now with 2 out and the bases empty, it's Wilson Contreras. The 1-1 home. Hard hit to first. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. 3 up, 3 down for the Cubs. They still lead it 2-1. Last half of the 7th here, and now it'll be the catcher, Austin Nola.
Know you're only down one right here, but the exploding stuff that's coming out of the back end of a lot of teams' bullpens, I mean, just north of 95 plus, stuff diving all over the plate, it's gotten a lot tougher to scratch across runs against these teams' bullpens.
And he lays off ball four, so now the potential tying run here is aboard late in the game.
Man, that's a tough one to swallow. You're hanging on to a slim lead, and the last thing you want to do is give up a leadoff walk. Seems like those are the ones that always come back to haunt you. So we'll see if that's the case here.
Jurickson Profar will come on to pinch hit here in a big spot. We're in the 7th inning now of a pitcher's duel. 2-1 our score. And he lays on for the ball. 2-1. From the stretch.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
Here it is, Padres on 3-1. And he missed with it. Ball four. So that means now the potential tying run will move into scoring position at second. And the hit will be Trent Grisham, trying here to plate the tying run from second. Now the 2-1 is a sacrifice attempt at least, but he can't get it down.
You have to find a way to get this bunt down right here. Advance the runners, get him into scoring position, second and third. Anything you have to do to execute this bunt needs to be done right here.
And this is swung on and missed, and boy, they took care of a key man there. One away. Andrew Chafin takes the call from the pen as he'll try to get the final two outs of this seventh frame. Stepping in now, Fernando Tatis Jr. 1-1 pitch and a good sinker there, but he can't find the zone. 2-1. Comes set, now the pitch. High and deep to left center field. Back goes Peterson to the track, to the wall. Three-run shot to left center, and they will jump ahead here. It's now 4-2.
Well, people always wonder why some players make so much money, and there's your answer. The great ones find a way to rise to the occasion in the postseason, and he did right there.
At the plate now, Manny Machado. And this is foul tipped at the plate right off the arm of the catcher behind the plate. Ouch. And that one got a piece of it.
Well, when you hear people talk about the unwritten rules of baseball, I think we just saw a perfect example of that. You hit one of mine, and I'm going to hit one of yours. Always been that way and probably always will be, even though they've tried to crack down on that kind of stuff recently.
In now, Eric Hosmer. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two.
Hey, I'm not sure what he was sitting on right there. Might have been sitting on an off-speed pitch, but instead, he gets the fastball way late. Had no chance to put that ball in play.
To the plate now, Tommy Pham. Hit on the ground to third, right to Bryant. And the throw to first is in time, but the damage has been done as the side is retired. But the Padres pick up three on this three-run home run. Seven complete here tonight, and the Friars have doubled up. They lead it 4-2. Emilio Pagan has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 14, Emilio.
Javier Baez will stand in here hoping to duplicate what he did back in the second inning. We flash you back to take another look at a solo home run that helped get this offense rolling. The 1-1 takes a pass and misses. That's strike two.
Put that in the memory bank. First time he breaks out a curveball right there, and it's a pretty good one.
Grounded up the first baseline. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Pham comes in a few steps as he hauls it in for the first out. So one gone here in the Chicago eighth, and in steps a former World Series hero, the outfielder Jock Peterson. And it's fouled away. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Grisham is there now, and he has it, two gone.
The batter
in
three.
Now is Nico that Horner, 0-for-2 with a Nico walk for him so far. Horner. Getting late, 4-2 our score as we play the eighth inning. A shot down the first baseline, and Hosmer won't be able to get a glove on it. It's a fair ball. He'll get it into second, but he'll be in there with a double.
As we look again at that double here, you can see that he was thinking, too, right out of the box. Smashed it down the line, and that was some great hustle to beat the throw to second to earn himself a double.
Standing in now, Jason Hayward. Ball and two strikes now.
One ball, two strikes.
Hey, this is a huge out right here. Two outs in the eighth inning. If this guy comes in and does his job, they hand it over to that beast in the ninth.
Fouled away. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. Now another 1-2. Oh, high. Deep. That is a moonshot, folks. A long home run. So a two-run homer down the line in right, and we are tied again.
Talk about it being a game of inches. That ball stays barely fair to tie this ball game up. Late innings. You have to be feeling super confident rounding the pillows after tying this one up.
Cameron Maybin will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Number 15, Cameron Maybin.
The 1-1. And that misses 2-1.
Somebody's getting frustrated. He's not used to getting hit around like this.
The set and the 2-1. And he checks his swing. Did he go around? Yes, says the first base umpire. Strike two. Two pitches fouled away. Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. Two for the Cubs in the inning on the strength of this two-run home run. Bottom of the eighth coming up. All even now at four apiece. Brandon Workman is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 45, Brandon Workman.
Bottom of the inning now, and that'll bring forth the veteran outfielder, Will Myers. The 2-1. Right side. He'll get to this one deep in the hole. throw in time at first. A nice play in short right for the first down.
Not sure the spin throw was necessary there, but it sure looked good. Would have been questionable if he threw it away, but he put it right on the money for the out.
At the plate, Jake Cronenworth. 3-1. You see a right-handed batter waiting next, but he could very well be pulled back as the situation dictates. And he fouls this one off. Crowd gets up for the 3-2. Lifted the other way out to left center. Peterson giving chase. And he tracks it down. A nice running play to record the second out. Next to hit, Austin Nova. A couple of walks for him thus far. From the windup, the 1-1. Up high, 2-1 now. Fastball just missed above the zone. We're in the eighth inning now of a 4-4 ball game. High in the air down the right field line. And this will wind up a foul ball. Into the windup. The payoff pitch. And he watches a called third strike on the cut fastball that time, and that will retire the side. Three up, three down for San Diego. Still all square at four apiece. Now the skipper's on his way out toward the home plate area, and I believe that means we're going to have a double switch here. Tim Hill will come on to pitch now as he'll move into the eighth spot in the lineup on the double switch here. Victor Caratini is into the ballgame as well as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting ninth now on the double switch. Digging in, the switch hitter, Ian Happ. It's been an 0-for-2 effort for him to this point. The 1-1 home. There's a slider taken for the ball. All even now, 2-2. Here it comes.
Full count.
Waiting next is Anthony Rizzo. All set. Here's the 3-2. Oh, and here's a drive. Well hit out to straightaway center. Grisham's on the warning track as he hauls it in for a loud out number one. Now at the plate, Anthony Rizzo. His prior history versus this arm. Not a big sample size, 0-for-1. Bases are empty, one man out. A piece of this one to foul it toward the backstop. A 1-2 pitch. Gets in looking. Strike three. Here's Chris Bryant now. He's got one hit in four at-bats. Two out, nobody on. One ball and two strikes to count. A 1-2 pitch.
Two-two.
Really pulled that one across as the slider misses well inside. And right into the shift. Machado has it.
Throw to first, beats him easily, and the side is retired. Cubs are down in order. Score remains tied at four. All set for the bottom of the ninth. And next to hit is the catcher, Victor Caratini. Pitch taken several inches below the zone, in fact. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. Almost got him to go around, but instead it's ball three. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Tough curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at-bat going. Another full count pitch home. Hard hit ball to second. And he will whip this one over to first in time for the out. So the lineup flips over, and digging in, Trent Grisham, who comes into this appearance in the midst of a 1-for-4 day. And the 2-1. Now a fastball gets the upper part of the zone for strike two.
That's a real nice location with that fastball up and in on the hands. Hard to do much with that because a hitter really can't extend his arms very easily.
Struck him out. Struck him out again, I should say. His third punch out of the game.
It's been a rough game for him at the plate. Couldn't get the bat off his shoulder right there, and he struck out twice before that one. So he's going to have a lot to think about when he leaves the ballpark tonight.
So now to the plate, Fernando Tatis Jr. Fouled off. He's ready, the payoff pitch. And he lays off ball four. So now the potential winning run is aboard at first.
Man, you hate to give up a two-out walk to anybody, but especially to a speed demon like him. Good chance he's running here, and good luck trying to stop him.
Kyle Ryan takes the ball, needing to get the final out of the ninth to send this one to extra innings.
Number 55, Kyle Ryan.
Manny Machado will be the first to greet him here as he stands in with a runner at first and two away. Before the pitch, a check on that winning run at first. Runner's back. Lifted down the line and left. Swing there as they tie him up inside for the third strike, and the inning is over. Padres lead one. This game's all tied at four. Keone Kella takes the mound as he'll be the first man to pitch here in extra innings. Now to the plate, Wilson Contreras. He grounded out last time up. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Three balls and a strike to the Chicago leadoff hitter. Javier Baez is on deck. The 3-1. Swung on and missed. The full count now.
When you get yourself to a 3-1 count and you get a fastball, those are the ones you really want to punish. Couldn't get the bat on it, so we'll see if that comes back to haunt him.
The 3-2 pitch. And he lays off. Ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here.
Just a nice piece of hitting right there, especially in extra innings. He didn't try to win the thing by himself or be a hero. He just patiently worked the at-bat until he earned the walk. We'll see if his teammates can pick him up now.
And that brings up Javi Baez. Go-ahead run at first. Nobody out. Now the 2-1.
Hit right.
Action in the bullpen now as a right-hander begins to throw out there. This is on the ground over to first. There's one. Over to Hosmer. A double play.
That's one of the hardest double plays to turn right there because of the difficult throw the first baseman has to make. No problem this time, though, and they get the two outs they were looking for.
Into the box, Jock Peterson on the run. This one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now.
I'll tell you, he just doesn't look comfortable in the box to me tonight. He's been off balance with his swings, and that one completely tied him up.
Myers gets under it and makes the catch to end the inning. Cubs are down quietly, still all square at 4 apiece. For the Padres, Eric Hosmer, for his career in this matchup, batting at an even 400. Set to deliver on 2-1. The count now at 2-2. Here's the pitch. And it's fouled away. Here's another 2-2. Swing and a liner. But this will be speared at third, and that was self-defense all the way. One gone. Ready for the bottom of the 10th here. And standing in is the veteran outfielder, Tommy Pham. Hit in the air down the right field line. Hayward on the run, and this will find the wall deep in the corner. And he will make it into second base as the winning run is in scoring position now with only one away.
Hey, nice piece of hitting right there to put the winning run on base. I know there's one out in the inning. They got one more to play with that they could potentially be productive with, but this guy's looking to end this right now and put something in a gap.
So here's Will Myers. His day at the plate hasn't amounted to much, 0-for-4, but this is a great opportunity to make amends.
Well, when your team really needs you, like they need it right here, you have to be able to put your personal struggles out of your mind. Right now is all that matters.
Possible game winners at second base here with one away. Now a pickoff play at second. A dive, but he's back. The 1-1 pitch. Hard hit ball to second. And that's through. A base hit. And they will lead the series 2-1 as they walk off winners.
Man, the postseason always seems to deliver big moments, and this was no exception. A walk-off in the final at bat ends it. And there's Bedlam at home plate. Wow!
evening's game comes to an end. 5-4, the final tally. San Diego take a 2-1 advantage in this division series. Keone Kellogg is the winning pitcher of record. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com.
The final line score for our ball game tonight. For the victorious San Diego Padres, 5 runs.